see the dot. That means I'm on.
Okay. Hi. Yeah. This is Big Sur. Okay, now I'll just do some of this.
Did you get that cloud?
That cloud? Let me just, tell me if I'm gonna like fall off this.
No, no, you got a long way. Hit. Like 4 feet. Yeah, don't just keep walking.
Oh, I love that sound. State Park.
I'm gonna wave at all the pictures.
All these big giant redwood trees. Soon I will tip over. Yep, it's 441, except it's really 341. And we're entering Los Padres National Forest. We're in Universal Studios.
Now I want to take a picture of Marilyn Monroe.
Oh, man, Marilyn Monroe. I thought, oh gosh, I'm in
Old Chicago from the movie The Sting, starring Paul Newman and Robert Redford. Most of the buildings you see down there are facades or Western Front, which won Universal its first Academy Award for Best Picture. Now, those buildings were built back in the days of silent film. They're not facades, they're practical sets. That is, they do have real interior rooms. Of course, back in those days, they didn't have sound stages. Nowadays, we do all of our interior filming and videotaping inside sound stages. Guy with all the gold around his neck, Mr. T. Actually, there were 7 of those vans for the A-Team series. Most of them didn't even have engines. They were just to be shot up or blown up or burned up or otherwise destroyed in the course of filming.
To escape, move forward immediately or we will blast you.
I explained to them that they're making a big mistake. Now, wait a minute, over here on my side of the tram, up on this pedestal, this guy looks kind of official. Hi there, sir. Ooh. Hi. Who are you?
I am the Imperious Leader, and you are now under my control. You will be vaporized in 30 seconds.
Vaporized?
Centurion, activate the death beams.
Death beams? Okay, that's enough. Wait, you think you can break through these doors, we can escape from here?
Silence, humans. Escape is impossible.
In the name of the Federation, I demand the release of the humans.
Apollo,
alarmed. It's on fire many times a day. It has been for many years now. The flames are real. They're gas jets mounted behind the windows. But the building, of course, is made of non-flammable.
Arnold Schwarzenegger's newest film, directed by Ivan Reitman, who directed Arnold Schwarzenegger in Twins with Danny DeVito. When we have a huge cast doing a movie down here, we usually put him up in our bungalows for the whole summer. Off to my side is the art out of everything except what they aren't made out of. Look like they're made out of brick, stone, concrete. What they're made out of is foam rubber, styrofoam, plaster, and a lot of chicken wire to hold it all together. That's so we can repair them very easily and tear them down very easily. Being the biggest and busiest lot in Hollywood, we need to be able to mount a production really quick. And off to my side, this little brick house. This was used in the TV series McMillan and Wife with Susan St. James and Brock Hudson. Got a Sergeant Enright's house. As we're turning onto this street, those of you fans of Janet Jackson's music should recognize this area. Her music video, All Right, with Cab Calloway, shot entirely on location here. And off to my side, this is Sting Alley from 1973's movie The Sting with Paul Newman and Robert Redford. Diana Ross scrubbed the brownstone steps on the driver's side in Lady Sings the Blues. And Women of Brewster Place with Oprah Winfrey was filmed entirely on location here also. It's more business orientated. That's to aid us in a little movie magic. We'll put the camera in the center of the street where the tram's sitting. As we turn the corner here, we're coming onto New York Street. Notice the ends of New York Street are curved. That's to give the illusion of length. Because if you can't see the end of the street, it gives the illusion it goes on much further than it actually does. This was Seattle, Washington, for the movie Harry and the Hendersons, with Jonathan Lithgow. And Demi Moore walked down this very street, and a freak hailstorm happened to her in the movie Seventh Sign. And off to my side, this prescription drugs, it says, Flower Shop Houseplants, Corner Green Building here, was where Clint Eastwood sat eating his lunch one day He looked across the street to the driver's side, saw that gold building being robbed. It was a bank. He got out his gun, went over and said those famous lines, "Go ahead, make my day." The film, of course, being Dirty Harry, produced by Warner Brothers Studios. We're about to show you an example of an interior-exterior sound.
Police admit that they are powerless to stop the enraged beast. Military units are rushing to the scene. The beast was last sighted near the 200 block from Fulton Avenue. We now go to live coverage of the scene with our helicopter reporter, Kelly King.
We're now hovering above the wreckage of a crushed L train. The helicopter beside us is searching for... Wait! There's a tram load of people down there! We've got to go down and warn them! Attention, people on the tram! You are in danger!
What are you guys talking about? Is she talking to us? What the heck is going on? This is the only way into safety. Uh-oh. I said on the bridge. Ladies and gentlemen, it's King Kong. He's got a hold of the bridge cables. Everybody just hang on. Stay calm. Yard sequence or any shipping warehouse yard simply by using the backs of the facades, so we don't have to build a whole curves a little bit. And that was it. Matlock has been used in this area the last couple of days. Andy Griffith could be on the lot today. He's been driving old-fashioned cars. He really likes these old Model T's. He has this episode of The Bionic Woman with Lindsay Wagner jump off backwards. We filmed that and then showed the film footage in reverse. That's how we create those bionic stunts. Of course, the episode in which we use that bridge.
Yeah, so cool. Photographing something beside these buildings. You might want to point those cameras to the top of that hill. Last time I heard that sound, some strange things happened. I got their cars in shape for you. Chevy Chase, Steve Martin, and Martin Short. We're seen riding through here on Orion's Pictures, The Three Amigos. Off to my side, you'll see this livery stable. Well, out of Mexico and into Texas. 6 Points, Texas, that is. If you look around you, the reason they call it 6 Points, Texas is because there's 6 streets and they all end up in this one central area. Film days, it was possible to shoot 6 films here at one time. Team posts and signs, we can make this any western town we'd like it to be. Back in those silent film days, Carl Lincoln. 53 in use for the Mississippi Gambler, signing Tyrone Power. And on the other side of that riverboat is the Pacific Ocean. Well, at least it was for McHale's Navy. That is the only ocean that show ever saw, starring Ernest Borgnine and Tim Conway. Now, rumor has it they left a few underwater mines out here. I don't know, loud and proud, or you won't be able to part a teacup. Here we go. Ready? One, two, three. A valiant effort, and there goes the miracle. Now, the waters were originally parted in 1923 by Sesamita Mills. He used a frozen block of gelatin, cut it in half, melted it back together with gas jets, and reversed the film, creating the illusion the Red Sea was parting. Then again in 1956 with Charlton Heston, they used 10,000 extras walking down a dirt road, and they put matte paintings on both sides of them. Now, to go through the Red Sea, you might want to get your cameras out, get a nice photo here at sea level. Keep your eyes open for those mines. You never know when one might pop up. And we all know a mind is a terrible thing to waste. Now you might want to get those passports out. We're heading on into Europe. This could be in a European town just by changing the languages on the buildings. This was Germany from Mad Max. This is where we shot All Quiet on the Western Front. It was Italy for Murder, She Wrote. In Georgetown for the 20th Century Fox production of War of the Roses, starring Michael Douglas and Kathleen Turner. In fact, it was right here on this hill that Kathleen Turner gave Michael Douglas the car in the beginning of the film. Of course, it was all covered with snow then. It might feel like we're riding on cobblestones, but we're not. When the cement was wet, we have molds, much like a cookie cutter mold. I came out here and pressed them out. Now they got those cameras, you might want to focus them off to my side of the track. Starting launching. It was here in this court that all of Universal's monsters first made their debut appearance on film. Frankenstein, Dracula, The Hunchback of Notre Dame, The Wolfman, and The Mummy. Ooh, scary. Dean Stockwell. Are they giving us clearance again there, Stanley? See the subway. Off to the driver's side, you can see some of the lights and flags that they're using for the film. Now look at the detail that goes into these sets. This film is taking place in 1983, so you notice that the telephones and newspaper stands are all from that 1983 time period. Billy Nicholson. Side, you can see we're headed a couple of weeks. Apparently they've had some sort of shark sighting out here. I'm not quite sure what that's all about. But we don't receive the memo and we're not supposed to be on the walk. Clippers, he's just been out there playing. George, no, George! Oh, George had a lot of guts being on that water. Ooh, and there they are. Yes. Well, I put some bait on a hook and I tied it to that yellow buoy out there. Let's see if we can catch ourselves a shark. Alrighty, got the bait. Oh no, I got the pier! That, of course, is a shark with jaws. He's got this terrible habit of spitting. We can't seem to break him of it. Across the water, you'll see that white boat with the red bottom. That was Ben Gardner's boat in the film. If you remember, Richard Dravis was looking for the lost fisherman and his head popped out of that hole in the bottom. There, of course, is the Orca boat where the three men chased down the shark, or rather, the shark chased them down. Well, that shark has a name, Steven Spielberg. Now, does anybody remember what kind of a shark that was?
Shark!
What kind of was it?
Shark!
No, it was a rubber shark, but thanks for playing. Across the water, if you look at that set again, you'll notice that's another ship from another show.
Festival Whorehouse. Chicken.
Time's up. That's Miss Mona's Chicken Ranch from the best little whorehouse in Texas. Starring Burt Reynolds and Dolly Parton. Now this grass out here, that's where Angela Lansbury does all of her gardening in Murder, She Wrote. And next door to that, in that greenhouse, the Brick Mountain, that's where Jimmy Stewart lived in Harvey with his invisible rabbit. And next to that is 1313 Mockingbird Lane, home to the Munsters. And the yellow house of the brick is where Dee Wallace Stone lives in Lassie. And the gray house of the yellow trim is where Doris Day and James Garner lived in the thrill of it all. Rumor has it, Doris Day's lived in every house on the street with a different husband in a different film. Across the way, you'll see a colonial house. That was used in Uncle Tom's Cabin, a film in the 20s. It was also used for some episodes of Quantum Leap starring Scott Bakula and Dean Stockwell. Off to my side, you'll see this white, you'll see the Glen Ridge Community Center. Just by changing these buildings around. In fact, we did that not too long ago for a film we shot out here called The Burbs, starring Tom Hanks. In fact, if you look off to the range and where neighbors the Kopecks live, and of course, right next door is where Tom Hanks lived. Now, Tom Hanks is familiar with that house. A few years ago, that house was painted pink. And that's where the Virgin Connie Swales lived in Dragnet, starring Dan Aykroyd and Tom Hanks. Still on to the driver's side, you'll see this greenhouse with the white trim. That's where Nancy Drew lived, in Nancy Drew and the Hardy Boy Mysteries. And then you got the White House with the green trim. That's where Andy Griffith lives, in the Viacom production of Matlock. And the brown house with the brown trim, that's where Vincent Price lived, in the House of Seven Gables, at 12 vacancies. And it was run by a strange proprietor by the name of Norman Bates. And he lived in the house on the hill with his mother. If you look off to the driver's side, you can see the Bates Motel and that's Psycho House, starring Anthony Perkins and Janet Leigh. Now we're going to take a closer look at the Bates Motel and the Psycho House. Now the Psycho House looks a little farther away than it actually is. That's because it's built on a three-quarter scale. Revamped. They shot a movie of the week out here called The Bates Motel, starring Jason Bateman. Now, I've been by here a couple times already today, and I haven't been wanting to say anything because I don't want you people to think I'm crazy or anything, but... And all the sound of the knife slashing into Janet Leigh's movie blood. Movie blood on a black and white screen turns gray, so they ended up using chocolates. Meaning we don't film inside. Just off to the right of it, you'll see that little wilderness area. In the television series Lassie, whenever she needs to find someone lost in the mountains, well, that's all the farther she needs to look. That little cat. Now, they had to dye that water blue to match the Bahamas. The only problem they had with that was every time one of the actors fell in the water, their hair would turn blue. It's all snowed in. Folks, I'm going to have to ask each and every one of you to be extremely quiet as we go through the ice tunnel. If an avalanche was to occur, we would plunder to the ground thousands of feet, be covered with tons and tons of snow. We would be frozen for hundreds of years until little scientists... Well, that's another story for another time. So I'm going to have to ask each and every one of you to be extremely quiet as we go through the ice tunnel. From this point on, no talking. Lunch. E.T. is a shining example of the magic of movies, but the magic...
Taurus Mordor is imprisoned once more, and by my sword, there he shall stay.
And so it was, an age of mystical wizards and swords and sorcery.
Come out.